If you've ever thought to yourself, I've got a whole bunch of these battery packs and I'd love to be able to use them to power my projects. Well, today we're going to talk about low voltage protection, which is a simple circuit, costs about 15 bucks off the internet, and it's going to keep you from over-discharging these, which means you can use them for whatever you'd like. Let's get started.
Five, four, three, two, one.
Now, in a world that's quickly evolving, the technology behind power tool packs has come a long way. The cost has gone down, the weight has gone down, and the power has really increased quite a bit. People are finding uses for these where engines were once used, in mobility, in toys, in all sorts of creative projects that many people haven't even thought of yet. The purpose of this video is not to tell you what to use battery packs for. That is completely up to you and your imagination. But I do want to share one of the biggest obstacles I had in using these battery packs for my projects, and that's low voltage protection. You see, lithium ion batteries have a floor to which you don't want to over discharge them, because if the battery gets drained too low, well, it makes for a bad day. Worst case scenario, it kills the battery. Enter low voltage circuit protection board. We've got the battery inputs, we've got the powered outputs, we've got our low voltage cutoff button, and we've got our differential button. Now, the nominal voltage for this battery pack is 20 volts. It has 5 lithium ion cells at 4 volts each inside, and when I get this wired up, you'll see it's currently holding 19.2 volts, almost fully charged. Now, if I click the low voltage setting button, you can see it's currently set from the factory at 14 volts. This is the point at which the cutoff circuitry is going to stop allowing the battery to discharge. Now, if I hit the other button, this is the differential setting, and that's how many volts the battery has to increase once again to turn the circuit back on. This is to prevent oscillation in our circuitry. So let's take a look at an example of how this can be used. So we're going to go ahead and wire on the output side a DC motor, a gear motor that spins at 80 RPMs through a motor speed controller. These are both available online. They don't cost a whole lot, but it's a great example of what we can use these battery packs for. So if I let this run, it would eventually drain the entirety of the battery down to a point where the battery would no longer take a charge. And that is the risk of using these battery packs for your projects, is if you drain them too far, you'll damage the battery pack and your chargers won't recognize them. So let's test it out. Here I've got another battery pack with 18.7 volts, almost fully charged. Now I've set the low voltage threshold to 15.3. That's where I'm comfortable with my packs. The differential is still set to 1.5 volts. Now once the circuitry triggers, it's going to go back up to 16.8 volts before it'll close the circuit again. That little LED indicator tells us that it's allowing power through the system. So let's turn on our gear motor and we'll let it drain our battery. Yep, this part took a really, really long time. Now here we are draining right down to the last tenth of a volt. And there it goes. You can see the LED indicator clicks off. Our battery has hit 15.3 volts. The circuit has protected it. Here's the test. Can it still be charged? And there you have it, folks. We can now use our battery packs for whatever we can come up with. Now, this is absolutely not a design guideline on how to use power tool packs for your projects. So please, you know, this was the biggest hurdle for me, the low voltage protection. I understood voltage requirements, I understood the current, but the low voltage protection piece of it was my obstacle from feeling comfortable using my power tool packs in my project. So hopefully this helps you out. I'll put a link down below as to where you can get this on the internet. Like I said, it's about 15 bucks, and I'll even throw in a link for where we can get these things. DC motor. DC motor speed controller. Actually, these three components in a battery pack can make an absolute ton of different projects. So, hey, speaking of projects, if you've got some projects that you use power tool packs for, throw them down in the comments below. I would love to hear what you're doing. I find just as much inspiration from the everything that everybody else shares. That's why we do this, is to help each other get better. So please comment as to what your projects are, what you'd like to do with battery packs, because boy, oh boy, you could do a lot with these things. So as always, if you appreciate the video, hit like, and please consider subscribing. We'll see you next time.